Inshore fishing for tripletail has always been one of my favorite types of fishing around my home near Beauville Bay. But it's been a while since I traveled back to the places of my childhood in and around the panhandle of Florida. This week I traveled to Apalachicola, Florida, a charming fishing village that is more like Cape Cod than Deep South. With Apalachicola's protected waters and shallow bays, many different inshore species thrive and make for some excellent fishing. I've been invited to venture out with one of the best captains around the area. Captain Mark Butler of Tripletail Charters is offering to give me a guided tour of his backyard, along with sampling the abundant tripletail fisheries found in the Apalachicola waters. Join us this week along the heart of the Forgotten Coast, coming up next, right here on Gary Finch Outdoors. When we arrived in historic downtown Apalachicola, we found a quaint village filled with southern charm and maritime architecture, as well as beautiful B&Bs and locally owned shops. We met with our guide for the weekend, Captain Mark Butler, and took a ride along the Apalachicola River, which brought with it beautiful views of nature and childhood memories for me.
There's another river coming down this side. Another river that goes out to the bay.
And then we looked this up, what this grass is called, right?
Hyacinths.
Yeah, there's either bald eagle or osprey nest. It's over on the left-hand side, but we're going over to the right. Now, I know a lot of y'all are really interested in birds of prey, which you got the osprey and you got the bald eagle. I did a falconry show up in the state of Washington. And we studied the bald eagle while we were there. And believe it or not, some of these osprey nests can weigh a couple thousand pounds. And over the time, some of these large mature bald eagle nests can weigh up to 3 tons. I'm a wildlife nut. And the nice thing about it is I enjoy it 100% every time I'm outside.
Yep.
Nothing more exciting than to be out in the outdoors.
And this is beautiful old Florida down here, you know?
Gotta find some more. We called them Georgia thumpers when I was a kid. It's a black grasshopper. I mean, we've seen them that big. Not that big, but, you know, that big. And a lot of them are on these reeds. But when I was a kid, like I said, I was explaining a while ago, we call these a Georgia thumper. And they don't really have, I mean, when they eat, they're like a locust, I guess. But if you see, there's one, two, three right here. And like I said, they're huge. This is a male right here. And they got a pretty good grip. But you want to be careful. Like I said, this is a small male. You'll see them all through here. There's a huge female grasshopper there. But anyway, these things are pretty. You don't want to grab one. I mean, they're real sticky when they hold on to you. There's another one right here. This is a big female. But you want to make sure you grab both legs so she can't turn around and bite you. And they got pretty colored wings. I'm not going to make them fly because we're in the water, but this is the size difference. This is the male on the left, it's the female on the right. Extraordinary, neat animal or insect. But they will, as far as I know, they do just as much damage to a crop as any other grasshopper or locust would. So we'll put them back. All right, they're safe and sound. We'll let them go. They're all in these reeds facing the water. And there's a big one on top of the little buoy right there. And they're all over the place. And on the way over here, we were talking about seeing these things on the road during the summertime. And it's so neat to be able to come out here off of the Apalachicola River and actually see them.
We head out into Apalachicola Bay when we return to Gary Finch Outdoors.
The
Tripletail Tag and Release Program at the University of Southern Mississippi Gulf Coast Research Laboratory was implemented in 2001. It is the most current program to join the cobia and speckled trout release programs, which began as far back as 1989. For a number of years, the Gulf Coast Research Laboratory has achieved a working relationship with the fishing community and their events. This marine research laboratory relies heavily on anglers for their participation in tagging programs and data collection. It would be impossible for Gulf Coast Research to dedicate the manpower, hours, or geographic coverage that is required for a project this large. Along the Gulf Coast, more than 2,000 tripletail have been tagged from 1996 through 2008. Many of them were first tagged in the Florida programs in peninsular waters. 11% of the tagged fish have been recaptured and reported to the lab. Unlike cobia, it's been determined that tripletail do not necessarily follow a long-distance coastal migration route. It is thought that our Gulf Coast tripletail move even less than the Florida peninsula populations. It seems that most of the Gulf Coast fish simply move offshore during winter months and reappear in the same state waters during the summer. Further tagging and recovery will be an important part of determining whether that is actually the case along the Gulf Coast. If our fish are seen to be more resident, then proper management will be important to assure the success of local populations. While many fishermen may not be able to picture themselves wearing white lab coats, they are actually working in one of the world's largest laboratories. The tag that anglers are placing into fish are the actual experiment that will record age, health, growth, and movement of the tripletail. The University of Southern Mississippi Gulf Coast Research Laboratory will gather the data and provide the fishing community with knowledge that benefit the very species they tag. It is a relationship that has worked quite well for a number of years, and there is still plenty to learn about the tripletail. The next morning, we headed out further into Apalachicola Bay, sight fishing for our target species, the tripletail. It wasn't long until we found a tide line with some floating hyacinths that looked there. Promising.
He didn't spook, so he should still be there. That's his tongue, flip his tail. Tide line right now, and we see a lot of these tripletail get underneath these hyacinths. It's a little early in the morning to sight fish for them yet, but they'll turn on later as the day goes on.
There he is.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. Oh my God, he's right there. Look, he's eating your shrimp.
I need a shrimp. I'm not paying attention to what y'all are doing. I thought I saw you. See me leaning forward? I kept looking down there. I'm like, I see him.
Mark's 18-foot Renegade Flats boat is perfectly equipped for finding and casting the floating tripletail.
Oh my God, dude, big one.
Where
he's at? On the left side, see him? Left side.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull him.
He's
yeah, that's him, that's one I saw.
He's a good one. Now he's on the left side, I'll have the point.
I got you. There he is. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is a smaller fish than we've been looking.
That's not the one we saw. There's a big one in there. We're going to tag them. The University of Southern Mississippi has a tagging program for tripletail, and we tag about 100 fish a year. This guy is 14 and a half, 15. So we're going to get a tag in him and get him back in the water real quick so he's healthy. So what you want to do is flick a scale out of the way and then just pop it in. Now that fish is tagged and we got a measurement on him and we know who the angler is, and away he goes.
Small one.
Another small one.
Yeah, see him right there?
Yeah, we haven't hit that one yet. Oh, there, the big one's behind it.
Yeah.
See him?
He took my bait.
You're on.
I got the small one.
There's still a bigger one behind it. Oh my God. Come on, baby.
Shooting fish out of a barrel. Like shooting fish in a barrel.
Get that big one.
They're fast, aren't they? Back to the, yeah, there he goes. Right. Might be a keeper. We ran right by him and he went down and came right back up. All right, good job. Yeah. Way to go, way to grab him. Man, I'd rather get right around and look for him like that than anything in the world. Hold him up for you. How about that? Fish with Mark Butler out of Apalachicola. Nice fish. All right. Thanks, sir.
We visit the University of Southern Mississippi when we return to Gary Finch Outdoors.
Not only is it exciting to catch tripletail, but the researchers at the Gulf Coast Research Laboratory in Ocean Springs, Mississippi, are finding them just as fun to study and raise. Doctors Jason Lemus and Jim Franks gave us an exclusive tour of their aquacultural visitors pavilion and nursery, where they have several projects in the works.
We've got, I think, 10 tripletail in here that are probably anywhere from a year to 2 years old, just judging by the size. We've captured these fish this spring. I believe in May, brought them back to our facility, and they're just about finished with that period of time where we feel comfortable they don't have any diseases that can be transferred to other fish. So we'll probably hold these fish till late summer, and in hopes that our previous research, which has shown that you can hold them over the catch them early spring and hold them over the summer, and they will start to go through that maturation process. So the hope is that that can be repeated, and then we can get them to spawn in those tanks that I showed you earlier, our broodstock tanks, where we can actually have them in the tanks and have the spawns come out of the tank and into a collector, and use those to start trying to do some studies with the larval rearing component.
It's an important part of our research project, of our research program at the laboratory, to try to learn a lot about the life histories, the behavior, feeding habits, the spawning of all of these great fish that occur here in the Gulf, particularly these pelagic fish such as tripletail, wahoo, tunas, and we're actually here at this facility trying to spawn tripletail in captivity.
So I'm gonna try and see if we can get some of these guys eating pellets. They're a little skittish still. They're down at the end of the tank. You can see them down there. These fish are more than likely a year old, perhaps some of them as old as two. They grow extremely fast. In the wild, it's perhaps reaching 12 inches to 14 inches within a year. In culture, they can reach that size in 6 to 8 months. We've had fish in captivity that have gone from 8 to 10 pounds to 20 pounds in less than a year. So we're very excited about the potential for these fish as an aquaculture species due to the extremely fast growth rate, docile nature, and a very good conversion of food to flesh, which is called feed conversion ratio. That's a big factor in the equation for whether or not a fish would be a good aquaculture species.
The next morning was absolutely beautiful, although the wind had started to pick up, with thunderstorms predicted to come in by the afternoon. The strategy was to get out to the FADs quickly and catch an early bite.
Folks, we're gonna start off fishing with live shrimp this morning.
Got Mark Butler running the boat. Gonna pull up on this tide line. There's some different structures floating with it. See what we can do today. Got a stick of bamboo out here. Mark, we're about 8-9 feet of water.
Six.
6 feet of water. There he is. Yep. There we go. Maybe so. It'd be nice if the first one's a keeper. Yeah. Got some power to him. It's a good way to start the day off, Mark.
Sure. On the board.
On the board.
Beautiful triple tail.
Just let him eat a little bit, right, Mark?
Yep. We're gonna let him go. Try to get a bigger one.
There he is. Yeah. Yeah. He's actually right through the center of it. No, he's through the center of it. See?
Push the rod through the fat.
Okay.
Push the rod through the fat. Out the other side. Hey, let go.
Got it.
Got it.
Yeah, he's right there. Jason, he's right there. Well, there's one way of catching him. You know? He didn't get away.
He did not get away.
Oh, he didn't get away. He ain't gonna get away.
Yeah.
How about that? Two for two.
Perfect. Oh, it fell right out of his mouth,
too. Good.
Look at that. It fell right out. Let's see what we got here.
About 15.
16, 17. 16. Nice fish.
All right, they're getting bigger.
We'll be right back with more Gary Finch Outdoors.
Fish on. Another fish. They're getting bigger. Getting bigger and bigger. We're hooking more of them.
That's a beautiful Apalachicola triple tail.
Isn't that nice? Go back and get another one. Man, where can you go and catch 25 triple tail in one day? Or one morning, I should say. Good acrobatics. Healthy fish, too. How about that? Thanks, Mark.
All right.
I have never seen any place with so many triple tail.
A healthy stock.
Mark, make sure you tell people they gotta be real careful. Don't put it back yet. Make real careful when they handle small fish.
Yeah, their gill plates are very sharp, especially the little ones. And then these things will poke you. The dorsal fin's got some needles.
And one thing about it, they'll send you to the hospital.
Look right there. Little one swam up to us, waiting for his buddy. he's looking at your little piece of shrimp.
It's 10 o'clock. We got out here at 9 o'clock. Put one in the boat and already tagged and released 7. So, ain't bad for 1 hour. All right. Sandwiches, baby.
All right.
that's two.
Strike two. Good job, Mark. Good job, man.
Boom.
Triple tail fishing in Apalachicola, Florida. Captain Mark Butler.
That's going to be a keeper.
At your side.
Yeah, he's 19.
All right.
Pretty fish going in the box.
All right. Good job. Good job. Captain Mark Butler, Apalachicola, Florida. There we go. Look at that.
Gary Finch.
Hey. That's dream team. Triple tail dream team. Uh-oh, be careful. No, we on to them now.
Yeah, everything's sharp. Yeah, there's one more there. You said you looked
for. Yeah. Folks, you gotta come to Apalachicola, Florida if you wanna catch a bunch. If you wanna catch a few, go anywhere else. If you wanna catch a bunch of triple tail, you come to Apalachicola, Florida. Woo! That's our show for this week. If you'd like to book a trip with Captain Mark Butler and Triple Tail Charters, please contact them at the information shown on the screen. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next week right here on Gary Finch Outdoors.